Then we had Walter and Ciampa, everything I could ever want in my life. I was so forward to this match. They gave it to me.
Match.
I thought it was the best match on the show by far.
You know what? I mean, I wouldn't argue that, but I really loved the tag title match too.
I like this one better. Because to me, the tag title match, they did briefly get heat, but what it was like just a collection of moves for like 15 minutes. It was just like one really long high spot, and it was really exciting and everything like that. But this match was violence. They told a story. They worked body parts. The psychology played into the entire match. Ciampa basically tried to destroy his chop hand. And
his fingers.
He tried to prevent him from doing the chop so he couldn't do the half crab. Walter's selling is just awesome.
Walter's fantastic. So the big thing that they did to get it over was Walter does a chop to the announcer's table, and they gimmick that top thing on the table. So he chops and the thing splits in two, and then he's selling his hand for pretty much the rest of the match. He actually really only came back with it like at the very end. You know, most of the match he's just selling it. Like, yeah, instead of doing a full crab, he's doing a half crab and doing it. He's trying to do a choke with one arm because the other hand can't get a grip, and hard hitting. And yeah, this was a super match.
So finally at the end, they're fighting up top, and Ciampa hits him with a middle rope emerald frozen, kind of. He just pretty much crushed him. Walter kicks out. Ciampa then tries a bridge to escape a hold, but Walter stomps his neck, twists his neck, power bombs him twice. Ciampa still kicks out. So Walter grabs him, gives him a sleeper suplex, and then chops him and pins him. He pinned him with a chop.
That was cool.
Oh, my God. Match of the decade. I love this match so much.
I wouldn't go that far, but it was a great match.
Oh, it was great. And then, yes, the tag team title match, Grizzled Young Vets, Legado del Fantasma, MSK. I mean, it's all moves. There's nothing to write down here. All moves.
It was super, though.
They did a million spots. There was one spot that I'm the only person, but I don't care. I hated this spot.
What spot is this?
So, Wesley gets put in the Skankly Gates.
Shankly Gates.
Shankly, whatever it's called. Shankly. They were pretty skankly to me. Okay, but Shankly. Anyway... He's about to tap out.
Oh, I know where
he... And he taps, and his partner grabs his hand to prevent the hand from touching the mat.
Right.
I'm like, bullshit. The fucking guy... When you tap out, like, it's not the act of touching the mat. You gave up. You submitted.
Yes.
And he submitted. His partner grabbing his hand does not prevent the submission. The guy gave up. But this referee's like, oh, well, you didn't touch the mat because your partner didn't let you put your hand on the mat.
That's a current pro wrestling trope that is done in the United States.
It sucks.
In different companies. It's actually, if you actually think about it logically, and you should
It's ridiculous.
It's absolutely, like you took the words right out of my mouth. It's ridiculous because if me and you are partners in a match, right, and you're about to get... Well, what was the situation here?
My tricep's going to be torn out.
Yeah, your elbow or whatever. Your elbow's about to get torn out. Okay, and I'm your partner. I'd let you tap because I like you.
Well, not just that. If I go to tap and you stop me from tapping, I'm like, fuck you, Dave. Why'd you turn on me?
Exactly. You're right. It's like the idea. I mean, the idea is that you know, you're saving the match, but it's like
and killing your friend.
If the guy's gonna tap, you know, it's like you know, you're not saving him. You're like putting him in harm. So, but I mean, you're not supposed to think that way. So it worked in that sense based on that you know, near fall and all that stuff. I mean, I got it. I got the mentality by it, but
I understood what they were supposed to do. Like, I understood it, but it's ridiculous.
Well, you're right. I understood it from the pro wrestling mindset, but as it was happening, I was thinking exactly how you were. I was watching that going like, you know, if you actually think about this spot, it is absolutely stupid. It's ridiculous. But anyway, the match kept going and Wesley and Nash Carter won the match. They should have won the match. Frickin' Raul Mendoza was frickin' awesome. And everyone was. But, these are three, you know, the Grizzled Young Veterans are very underrated, But the team that should have the belts right now are the team that won the match. They're the upcoming hot group, and they're a very, very exciting team. I mean, I've been watching these guys for years, and I'm so happy for them, you know, because, you know, they've just worked their ass off, and they've improved. You know, they were always good. I mean, Wes, I keep wanting to say Desmond, but Wes is a great athlete. He's almost like a Ricochet level athlete, but his wrestling itself has gotten so much better, and yeah, they're an exciting team, and the other two teams are exciting teams, and we'll probably have all kinds of great tag team matches for the championship coming up.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts. And also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.